To help support the show and learn more about the weapons tested and approved on this channel, please go to zombiegoboom.com.
When the zombie apocalypse arrives, will you survive? Zombie Go Boom. Kick undead ass.
Hey, what's up, survivors? Welcome to another mind-blowing episode from the bloodiest show on YouTube, Zombie Go Boom. Today we have a really amazing episode for you guys. A lot of you guys have been asking for us to retest the bathroom episode. A lot of Zombieland fans out there, and we are gonna do it, but I felt bad about doing it without a certain someone, so Jim Goza.
What's up, guys? Are you having a shitty day? Are you down in the dumps? Are you pissed off at this ever-mounting zombie horde? Would you like them flushed out of your life for good? Well, join me right now, Jim Goza, right here for this special reissue episode of Zombie Go Boom. We'll be testing on our brand new Ivanhead, the toilet seat, and the upper decker. Let's check out the tale of the tape.
So what happens when you're in the bathroom at the start of the zombie apocalypse and you are literally caught with your pants down? What do? What do you use? A curtain might be a good defense, but only for a short time. You need to find something deadlier. What about a plunger? Nope, it can help you push a zombie away, but it's not going to finish the job. In fact, we snapped one while testing it on a much softer head. What about a toilet lid? First of all, it's attached to the toilet, so the best you might be able to do is give your undead friend a really horrific swirly. If you manage to rip it off its hinges, however, you'll find it very hard to wield, bulky, slippery, and grossly ineffective.
Not a goddamn thing.
A curtain rod is too long of a weapon for a tiny space, and it's definitely not strong enough to break through a skull. That leaves only one logical weapon, the porcelain toilet tank lid made famous in the movie Zombieland. It's time to make a zombie go boom.
So this thing, I would say, weighs probably about 20 pounds. With all that force, that down force, right on that edge, I caught the top of the cranium right with this edge right here. That was enough to completely divot the entire top of the head in.
So, if you're stuck in the bathroom, make sure you grab the porcelain toilet tank lid. And remember to double tap.
Oh yeah, gotcha.
Well, this definitely doesn't work. Hit it flat, fell off, and it's gonna be hard to grab it in the first place because you have to rip it off of the toilet. That one's easy to find, and it totally worked.
Yeah.
What did you think?
You know, clearly it did just a supreme amount of damage, but also the blood splatter causes a lot of problems for you. If you have any cuts whatsoever that happen to be open, if you get it in your eyes, you're in the shitter.
Yeah. Not to mention it's ridiculously heavy. That's not a weapon that you would choose to carry around with you during a zombie apocalypse, but if you are caught with your pants down during the zombie apocalypse, this is actually a really pretty decent improvised weapon,
yeah,
I'd say.
It's not bad, it's not bad. It's certainly not the best, but it ain't bad.
Yeah, for weapons that definitely work and to help support the show, please go to zombiegoboom.com. With another mind-blowing episode from Zombie Go Boom, I'm Chuck Murray.
I'm Jim Goza, crappy hunting.
And if that's not enough of Jim Goza, you can check out his YouTube channel.
Yeah, guys, I feature, you know, live music of my own personally recorded songs just for your pleasure. I also do little comedy bits. There's all kinds of content for you guys to check out. Also, make sure to follow me on Facebook and Twitter. I have a very interesting twat just about every day.
And I'm going to put all of his social media links in the description below.
To help support the show and learn more about the weapons tested and approved on this channel, please go to zombiegoboom.com.